Ladies and gentlemen, I am the War Boss Squee, welcoming you to our first episode in our new series, Fallout. We are going old school, and I thought it was kind of appropriate. I'm a big Fallout fan. I've played literally all of them, including Tactics, which I'm still trying to get a new copy of so I can do that on this channel. And since Fallout 4 has just put out their final DLC today, and that game is no longer going to be supported after that, I thought it best if we did something a little bit old school and went and tried some old Fallout, because God knows it's a good game. Now, classic setup here. This hasn't changed at all for all of the different versions. We have our strength, our perception, our endurance, charisma, intelligence, agility, and luck, our special stats. Now, we have 5 points to put in here, so it is a little bit more difficult than it used to be. But first of all, charisma, go away. You don't need charisma, you need the speech skill. It's kind of weird like that. Strength will be up a little bit. Let's see our agility. I think this gives us action points and armor class. I'm gonna crank that up twice. We're going to want some more hit points. And we're going to want some more perception, because this gives us the ability to shoot people. High intelligence is always good, because that gives us skill points. And average. I think we're going to go with average luck. We're going to go with a little bit higher intelligence. All right, now we have our optional traits here, which are things like fast metabolism. Less resistant to radiation and poison, but your body heals faster. Bruiser. A little slower, but a little bigger. You may not hit as often, but you'll feel it when you do. Your total action points are lowered, but your strength is increased. And I think that'll actually crank my strength up to 8. Yes, yes it will. And we have small frame, which does the same thing in reverse. Lowers your strength, but gives you a boost to agility. One-hander, it's better accuracy with one-hand weapons, but two-handed weapons like rifles and miniguns aren't as good. Finesse is less damage and more critical hits. Kamikaze is more damage but less critical hits. Heavy-handed... No, actually, this is the difference of finesse. Kamikaze is... Alright, just... You get armor class just based off the armor you're wearing, not your agility stat. But you you act faster. And heavy-handed is more damage and less crits. Fast shot... You don't have time to aim for a targeted attack because you attack faster than normal people. Cost you one less action point to use a weapon. I do not see the downside to that one. Bloody mess. You always see the worst way people die. That gives you a damage bonus. Jinxed, not a good thing. We're not even looking at that. Good natured. You studied less combative skills as you were growing up. Your combat skills started at a lower level, but speech, first aid, doctor, and barter substantially improved. We want that. And skilled, I know I'm chem reliant. You're less likely to you get addicted faster, but they last longer. Chem resistant is you're less likely to be addicted, but they also wear off faster. Night person is intelligent perception increased at night. Skilled gives us. Spend more time improving your skills than a normal person. You start with better skill levels. The trade-off is that you do not gain as many extra abilities. You will gain a perk every 4 levels, which is actually not bad. And gifted. You have more innate abilities than most, so you not have as much time spent honing your skills. So your primary statistics are each plus 1, but you lose 10% on all skills to start and receive 5 less skill points per level. So if we were to hit gifted... And let's say good-natured. So that gives me a small guns of 23, which I can tag to put it up to 43. Let's see, sneak would be a 43. All my skills are really good for the most part. And so I'm losing out on big guns and energy weapons, which is not a huge deal. Melee weapons is still at 42. Throwing is at 28, but don't want to be using grenades anyway. First aid and doctor are good. Tag lockpick up to 58, And we'll tag speech up to 74. And that's about all you're going to need. Yeah, base 25% plus double your charisma. So I can have that maxed out very quickly. But it also gives me... Now I'm rocking a 7 strength and 8 perception, 7 endurance. Charisma's 2. Oh, well. Can I lower that even more? No, I can't. It's automatically set that way. A 9 intelligence, an 8 agility, and a 6 luck. So I'm missing out on some of these optional traits. I think I can take... No, I can only take 2. This is something that Fallout New Vegas brought back, and I was very happy to see them do so. Because you didn't get this option in Fallout 3, and Fallout 4 does... It's just... Fallout 4 is just not that much of a role-playing game as opposed to a first-person shooter. But that's okay, because I like Fallout 4. And yes, I know I'm inviting hate for doing this by saying that, but it's still true. So... Age 25, sex male. I think we're ready to go. Alrighty, so. Just want to make sure I'm doing this right. 10% off skills to start. 5 less skill points per level. I think we should be okay. Small guns will carry us for, God, most of the game. A lot of these we're not going to accept. Perceptionally need. Do I want to raise lockpick or sneak? Really not good at sneaking in this game, so there we go. Oh, look at those old graphics.
You're here. Good. We've got a problem. A big one. The controller chip for our water purification system has given up the ghost. Can't make another one, and the process is too complicated for a workaround system. Simply put, we're running out of drinking water. No water, no vault. This is crucial to our survival. And frankly, I think you're the only hope we have. You need to go find us another controller chip. We estimate we have 4 to 5 months before the vault runs out of water. We need that chip. We marked your map with the location of another vault. Not a bad place to start, I think. Look, just be safe, okay?
All right, so... And we are now exiting the vault. Now, this is a much beloved series for a lot of people, and it is actually the... spiritual successor to a game called Wastelander. A lot of people that worked on the first Wastelander worked on this, and this was actually supposed to be a sequel. But the company that owned Wasteland pulled out so that they had to go in a different direction, and I think it was for the better, personally. Now, is for those of you who are not familiar with the Fallout universe, first question is, why are you watching this? How do you not know what Fallout is? It's kind of a, it's like Star Wars at this point. It's kind of everywhere. All right, there's our character. Yeah. And there are rats aplenty. Now what I need to do is... All right, there we go. In my inventory, I have a... There we go. A knife, a 10mm pistol, a Colt 65-20 10mm auto-loading pistol. Each pull of the trigger will automatically reload the firearm until the magazine is empty. Single shot only using the powerful 10mm round, which is 40 caliber, for those of you that don't know the difference between gun types. Yeah. So we want to make sure that that... How do we equip this? I don't remember. No. There we go. We've got plenty of jacketed hollow point rounds. We've got some stim packs. 2 flares. I honestly have never figured out how to use those. We have some lock picks. And a tool. A super tool set containing various useful tools weighs 1 pound. Now, these are based off of... You get lockpicks because I tagged lockpicking as a skill. So it's kind of cool. And there we go. We now have... How many AP do we have? We have one, two, I think we have 10 AP. So, and if we search this guy, as soon as I remember how. Here we go. He had a combat, he had a knife, and he's also got some armor piercing ammo. But we're not going to take his knife. We're going to shut off the combat for the time being. And we are, of course, surrounded by rats. And we're going to kill a few of these guys for some experience. Come on. I apparently do not... I've only got 9 action points. I was kind of hoping I was going to have 10. How do I turn off combat? There we go. Now we need to get a lot closer to the rats to shoot them. Oh, there's one right there. Conveniently, this is going to be a 95% chance to hit. There we go. Got the rat. The cave rat was hit for 8 points and was killed. For defeating your enemies, you earn 25 experience points. Get close enough, they will come to you. I don't think he'll have enough action points to actually hit me. No, he won't. So, it's another rat down there. Then this one will mosey over, and we will just keep doing this process. There's a larger amount of rat feces in this area. Gee, I wonder what these things have been eating. Oh, I missed him. That's a shame. Wrong button. Ah, tried to kick the rat, didn't work. Combat cannot end with hostile creatures nearby. Alright. And turn right there. We're probably gonna get bit. No? He's just hanging out. Mr. Rat's happy. There we go. Shot the rat. He didn't die. Why is the rat not dead? But he could not hurt us because he's a rat. There we go. How many bullets do you have to put in a rat to kill it? Good lord. Now, as far as I know, there's absolutely nothing in here of value except for some items over here that we're going to try to get. Normally, when I play through this, I would stop and try to kill every rat that comes my way just for the experience, but it's not really a big requirement in this. There we go. Would have been really nice if I could get 10 AP, though. And you missed. See if we can make our way over to this item without getting attacked by more of these giant rodents. Oop. One more right there. Now, I am running the high resolution 4.1.8 patch. It makes the game a little bit prettier. Although, to be fair, not a lot. I could have sworn there was an item in those bones. Excuse me, Mr. Rat. I was trying to find something. Go away. All right. see. Bones. I thought there was a body in here. Apparently I am mistaken. Well, that's somewhat disappointing. I guess we're going to make our way out of the cave then. Like I said, we could stay here and just kill the rats, but we'll be coming back at some point anyway, because in a couple of days we can get back into the vault. Let's reload my gun real quick. And we are heading out into the world. To the west, you can see a natural light. For the first time in your life, you're looking at the outside world. Ah, it is 2161, December the 5th, at 7:23 in the morning. Now, the bombs dropped in 2077, I believe. So it's been about 90 or so years since the bombs fell. And this is our overworld map. It's pretty basic, but it gets the job done. As long as you know a location, you will head there unerringly, assuming that you haven't come across anything else. That town right there will be important in a minute. All right, Vault 15. And it even gives us a nice little layout, and we can pick our entrance. Small shack is all that remains of this area. Fortunately, your records indicate a secondary entrance to Vault 15 there. It's barely standing, seems to have been looted long ago. Let's see if I can interact with this. Ah, the ladder. Alright. There we go. Now here, the enemies are going to be a little bit more dangerous. I believe not only do we have rats, but we also have mole rats. I could be mistaken, though. That is a fairly big rat. Hello, fairly big rat. And I think we missed. I'm gonna try punching it. How's that for an idea? And we missed. Can we shoot the rat this time, please? There we go. Good and dead. Now, how many... Let's see. Our objectives are get the water chip. We have 143 days left. Yeah, not a lot of time. That's where is the thing that tells me how much experience I need for the next level... Here we go. We have 200 experience. We need 1,000 to the next level. So at 25 experience per rat, it's not quite worth it. A cool thing is that you can actually print off this character screen and like hang it on your wall and stuff. It's pretty awesome. Yeah, there's some bigger animals in there that we don't really want to mess with right now, but I think we should be okay. There we go. Here. You notice that there's a wall locker on the east wall, just like in your own vault. We will have to check that out in a moment. And here comes... What is that thing? She looks unhurt. I think that's a mole rat right there. took 9 points of damage. Yeah, that's a mole rat. And I just took 3 points of damage from that. That was not nice, Mr. Mole Rat. Go away. This one was critically hit for 6 points, seriously wounding the rat and knocking it around. It is, however, not dead. So we're going to try to hit it with an unarmed attack. There we go. For 4 damage. Yes, mole rats are tough in this game. They're a joke in every other Fallout game, but they are not a joke in this. And it is killed. Awesome. So let's see if we can get out of here. Have some flares, which again, I don't really know what to do with, but I'll take them anyway. So I can use them to barter with later. Do we have anything in the mole rat? Nope. Mole rat has nothing good in it. So, as you probably have guessed, the main premise is that our water chip in the vault is broken, and we don't want to have to leave the vault, so we are going to need a new water chip. And we were hoping that Vault 15 would be able to give us one. Unfortunately, as you can tell, Vault 15 doesn't look like they're going to be in a position to help anybody, much less themselves. I can't target that guy, so... A little bit closer, maybe? Now we got that one, at least. Let me see something here. I've never figured out how to use flares. So it doesn't look like there's anything in here I can actually use right now. A monitor, no power. A bed that's in bad condition. Nothing of great value here. Come on. Apparently, I cannot get out of combat until I kill this rat. Oh, that didn't do any good. So here we have a access tunnel leading down. An elevator shaft. The elevator shaft is not easily descended without a rope, so we won't be able to go anywhere. So, since we can't do anything, the only thing we can do is go back and make our way to that last town that we saw. Bad rat, come here. That's right, that's right, that's what you get. Alright. So that didn't work out too well. So, we do have the opportunity to go over here, though. So, Vault 15 was kind of a bust. We need a rope. The vaults come under some very bad times, indeed. Unknown area. Welcome to Shady Sand, stranger. Please holster that weapon while you are here. There we go. I don't know where my gun just went. Not there it is. Good day, I'm called Seth. How can I help you? I'd like some information. No problems. Tell me about the Rad Scorpions. Those damn rats are Jarvis. Oh, that went by really quick. I don't think it should have done that. Let's try that again. That's what last error is. Come on. Looking for an antidote as quickly as he can. Hey, if you have the means to help us, our leader, Aradesh. Alright. He's just building to the south. There we go. So, Aradesh is around here somewhere. There we go. I think he's in this building right here. Yep, there he is.
Greetings. Your business in Shady Sands might be...
I'm from a vault of the west. My people are dying of thirst. I need to find a water purifier chip for them to survive.
Wanderer, I shall believe you for now. You may enter Shady Sands, but be warned, your every move will be watched. Certainly. What do you wish to know?
What other towns are around here?
Junktown lies south of here, though there is little in the way of visitation. From stories, I'm certain there are cities south of that. Certainly. Yeah. What do you wish to know? Oh my, yes. Great packs of rad scorpions are killing our herds. We don't know where they're from, and no matter how many we kill, there's always more. And now the monsters are attacking my people. Roslo is trying to find a cure for their poison, but I'm not sure how it goes.
Well, I think we can help him out with that.
Yes. Please, talk to Roslo. He possesses far more information on these creatures than I.
All right, so they have a rad scorpion problem, which, to be fair, is a major problem, as rad scorpions are not to be fucked with. Let's talk to Roslo real quick. Oh, that's Roslo's wife. Distraught, are you in need of assistance? I need healing. My husband Roslo can help you ask him. Alright, so that's Roslo right there. I need healing. Of course you do. Let's see here. You're barely hurt. I suggest a good night. Alright. Let's talk about the Rad Scorpions. What do you know about Rad Scorpions? Not too much. They seem to be extremely... as I would expect. God bless it. Stop doing that. Seth has been hunting them, which helps some of my tests. And how such a me. You seem well educated. What are you doing here? Dr. Morbin jaded, have a nice day. Yes, yes, you were rude and were told to fuck off. Alright, and we can pick up a friend over here. Come on, go inside. There we go. And this would be... Now we'll click on him. Hello, stranger. You look like you're new here. What's your name? I'm Warboss. Good to meet you. And what do you do here? I was a guard for the Marines to make me useful here. Shady Sands is my home now. Occasionally, I even get to visit Junktown or the Hub to do some trading, since I'm the only person here who's ever... Help me out a bit. Your experience would be useful. Or how about a piece of the action instead? Alright, I'll help you out in exchange for my share of loot. Let's go. Good to be back in action. Now this is going to be useful because Ian's going to be helpful when we take on the Rad Scorpions, because trust me, you want two guns for those guys. Now, I believe I should be able to access Ian's... I can't get his. I've killed 14 rats. Hooray for me. Alright, Ian, how do I look at your inventory? Da, da, da. He's good with a pistol and a submachine gun and a knife, which is not bad. Could have sworn there was a way I could give him stuff. But let's talk to Seth and see about going into the Red Scorpion Cave. Are you sure you want me to give you directions to the Red Scorpion Caves? I can't go, but I can show you the way. Yes. You see the bones of a large two-headed cow. And this is where we're going to leave things off here for today. These are going to be shorter episodes as I get my feel back into Fallout. I haven't played this game in a long time. If you like it, hit the thumbs up button for me. Leave a comment. We're going to be doing this 2 days a week. So Tuesdays and Thursdays is going to be Fallout, and we're going to continue with our 3-day schedule for Soul Silver for the time being. Now, I'm the War Boss Squee. Thank you for watching. You guys have a good day. Peace out.